Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
At this time, I'm going to call the meeting to order. I only have the invocation. Let us pray, please. Our Father, we humbly come to you, thanking you for all our many blessings. I pray that you will bless this board and lead us and guide us as we try to make sound, impartial decisions as we work together for the common good of Alamance County. We pray for all our county leaders as they will face financial issues in the coming year that they have never faced before. And let us never forget the freedom that we have in this country and keep our soldiers safe as they continue to fight for this freedom. Keep us in your care each day, Lord, as we represent the citizens of Alamance County. These things we pray in your name. Amen.
Amen.
First thing on our agenda, do we have public comments? Sue Dayton, I recognize Sue Dayton at this time.
Ooh, that was quick. I just got here. Good evening, commissioners. Thanks for having me speak. And I'm going to make this short and sweet. My name is Susan Dayton. I am an Alamance County resident, and I'm a business owner, a homeowner. And I also happen to work for an environmental organization called the Blue Ridge Environmental Defense League. And I'm here tonight to tell you some more about sewage sludge spreading in Alamance County. I brought some information. First of all, I wanted you to know that just received a report from the State Division of Water Quality, and in 2007, for example, we had about 20 million gallons of sewage sludge spread on farmlands in our county. We receive sewage sludge from City of Burlington and Mebane. And of course, City of Graham has its own dedicated farm or field where they dispose of its sewage sludge, which in our opinion is preferable than, you know, putting it on farmlands where crops are grown for domestic animals and human consumptions. I want to share with you a photograph that I took, and Commissioner Boswell has already seen this because I've done a presentation to the planning board members last Thursday. This is a photograph that I took of sewage sludge that was spread on a friend of mine's property. He happens to be an organic farmer in Alamance County. And this sludge was spread by the City of Burlington, and it's 45 days old. The way the rules work for the spreading of sewage sludge, sludge is usually given to farmers for free to be used as a fertilizer for their fields. And in this particular case, after 30 days, cattle can graze on sewage sludge. And so the cattle can graze on this. This particular sludge, it had like a cardboard-like consistency, and unlike any fertilizer that I've ever seen. Our organization we're going to be showing a film called Sludge Diet, and it's a 50-minute Canadian-produced documentary on the risk of sewage sludge spreading. And this is this takes place in the United States as well as in Europe and Canada. And what I'd like to do is I'd like to give you a flyer on where the documentary is going to be held. It's going to be starting tomorrow night in Carrboro at the Century Center, Wednesday night at the Burlington Public Library, Thursday night at the UCLA Community Center, and Friday night at the Graham Public Library. And I would really love for you to come and see that.
And you know your time is up. We have a lot to go over.
Thank you for the 5 additional seconds. Also like to invite all of you to a forum we're having on June 4th with experts that will be discussing the risks of spreading sewage sludge on our farmlands. It's going to be held in Orange County at the Orange Cane Creek Baptist Church Activity Center. And as I said, we're having a listening panel, and we've invited one representative, at least one representative from each of the 3 counties involved with this, Alamance, Chatham, and Orange, to sit on a listening panel. And I hope that one of you will come and participate.
Thank you.
Thank you.
At this time, we will open the public hearing on the 2009-10 budget ordinance. If anyone would like to speak, I will recognize you at this time. Everybody speak here one time. Anybody else want to speak? At this time, I will let you know if anybody is going to say anything at this point.
I'm fine. That's what we've been working on here.
Dan, I'll see the other commissioners. I have a recommendation at the appropriate time on the budget, Madam Chair.
Okay. I think we probably need to do that in the commissioners' comments. Is that correct?
We would need to do that probably under discussion of the budget. If there's any discussion about the possibility of approving the ordinance.
Okay, we can do that now.
I do have a question for the county manager. In terms of the positions that were unfrozen, I think it was it 10 positions, nine positions?
9 positions, yes.
Is this the same ones that's on page 6 here of your, what you sent us?
Those are the ones that we have reclassifications and the one new position for the trail position. It doesn't include the unfrozen positions.
Okay, where are the other positions? Are they in this report here?
Yeah, they're listed. The unfrozen positions, what we are recommending, there's an administrative secretary in EMS. There is an ag extension agent, a physician, 3 in health, physician extender, 2 in health, environmental health specialist. I believe those are... Oh, yeah, 2 in DSS, a case worker, 2, data entry operator, 2, in the library, library assistant, 1, circulation assistant, 1, and a circulation assistant, 2.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate that.
What does that total come to?
240,000.
Okay.
Craig, on the ag extension. Now, I think Paul's leaving us now. Is that position, where are we on that, Paul Walker?
We would fill that position once it came up.
Okay.
So the dollar amount of the employees that you're suggesting that we put back in there is 240,000? Is that what you said?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How long were those employees not on the payroll? For those positions, not on the payroll.
Sherry would need to. I didn't write the information you need that says
let me, I'm sorry, I read the chart wrong. The ag extension one was eliminate, physician three was eliminate, environmental health specialist was eliminate. So out of the 11 positions currently frozen, we were eliminating three entirely from the budget and recommending to fill eight. Okay. And that was the library positions and the two in DSS and the MIS and the EMS secretary.
Okay, so that would be eight plus the reclassifications that we see here on page six.
Yes, sir. And the one new position for the trails.
Okay, on the Haw River Trail position, the in recreation, the cost to the county is going to be what?
$14,000.
$14,000, and the other, as far as his other salary, that's going to be picked up by?
Partly by Graham, partly by Burlington, and part by a continuation grant with the trails.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Can you answer my question? Yes, if the other commissioners don't have
comments on any of this,
yeah, I got you.
Go right ahead.
We were just shown tonight, and I'm still confused about having to vote on this with this just being shown to us. This Haw River Fire District tax requesting to go from 10.5 to 12.5.
Yes, sir.
Can we get somebody to discuss the finances of this? I understand the revenue neutral for them is 9 point whatever, and to go to 12.5, that would be, what, 25-30% increase in base tax?
Right. Revenue neutral is 8.92. Currently, they're at 10.5 cents, and they're requesting to go to 12.5 cents.
Okay. Can somebody... I understand that they're here tonight. Can they discuss this? Can somebody talk to us about that? Right. Anybody from Haw River here? Oh, I thought they were. Excuse me. How many of the fire districts did raise their versus going back to a revenue neutral?
One other than Haw River, Altima Hospice has recommended an increase, and that was going from 10 to 10.25.
And what was their justifications for that?
Just additional capital needs. I think there's some representatives here as well.
I'm not as concerned with that as I am the Haw River situation, not knowing any more of the details. I hate to have to make a decision on $130-some million budget based on one item that I feel like hasn't adequately been presented to us.
I did meet with their city manager on Friday, and he did tell me that the letter was coming. We got it today, and he said that they're in the process of doing a new pumper. And I think part of this came from a budget retreat that they worked on, and in reworking their numbers and looking at revenue figures, they felt like with the new pumper and the new debt service that an increase was justified.
The increase, Mr. Sutton, would add 42 more thousand to their budget if they go to the 12.5.
The revenue neutral for them was what,
8.92. And they're at 10.5 now.
So that's a 30-some% increase, is that mm-hmm. correct?
What is the 8.92 kit? Have you got that in? How much is the 8.92 kit?
It's 188,761. $188,761.
And that would be 42 more thousand under that.
Yeah. The fire departments did not go revenue neutral. Most of them stayed at the current tax rate they're at now.
Okay. Okay.
So right now they're at
222,197.
And then if they go to the 12, it would be an additional
42.
Right.
Well, I'd like to just go ahead and say how I feel about a few things. this is my 15th budget, and each year, sometimes it's easier to go home after we vote than how I think I would feel tonight if I went home supporting what's on the table. I think what's amazing to me is I don't think a lot of people in this room, I don't think a lot of people in this community, except for the general citizenry, understands what's happening in this country. We have bankrupted America. It's that simple. And everybody's coming up with a scheme to keep it going, from the White House all the way down to the State House, all the way to the courthouse here, possibly. We've got to, in my opinion, we've got to do things better. We've got to be more efficient. We've got to be cheaper. The cost of government just can't keep going up each year. And I know I have voted against budgets. I have voted for budgets. But in my opinion, this budget does not meet the tightness of what the times are laying out before us. It's hard, you know. I understand when you have a department, especially when you receive tax dollars, that you're not a profit and loss center, you're not a business, to the extent that you have to do without and have the attitude of I'll get the job done, even with lesser employees or lesser salaries, lesser benefits, and so forth and so on. Government just seems to keep rolling. The cost of government back when my parents or my age was roughly 20-some cents of every dollar from top to bottom for the cost of government. Now it's 40-some cents. I have two sons, 129 and 122, and there's no doubt in my mind that if we don't do something in this country, that they'll be paying close to 60-70% of every dollar for cost of government. And it's hard for me to vote for budgets that I think tend to push us towards that echelon. I got a survey from the County Commissioners Association, which I don't really participate in a whole lot. I call them when I need them. I'm not saying this is proof of anything other than I think it's worthy of reporting. This was as of last year, or really 2008, 2009, supposedly, has a list of all the counties in the state, has a list of what their the populations are given, how many county employees they have. And if you look at the counties that are roughly our size, now I know we all don't do the same thing, apples to apples, we've heard that over our lives, but by George, they have social services. They have human services, mental health, they have health department, they have sheriff's department now. Everybody's in doing something different, like we're one of the only counties out of the 10 that I'm going to mention here, not by name, but as a group, that's doing the 287G, that's where our jail population is double what some others are, so it's going to require extra staff. But even factoring out some of the things that we're doing that others aren't, there's some glaring numbers here that I have to report. There are 10 counties, roughly our size, in population. Roughly 10. Of the 10, 8 of them have a lower ratio of county employees per population unit, if I've made that clear. But let me give you 5 examples here. Cabarrus County has an average of, according to what these numbers show here that I've divided out and double-checked twice here, I could be wrong, but Cabarrus County is showing 1.4 less employees per 1,000 residents than Alamance County, 1.4. Randolph County, 1.5. Rowan, 0.5, half an employee. Iredell, half an employee. Davidson, a quarter of an employee. 2 examples in that group, Randolph County, they have an average of 1.5 less employees per 1,000. population units. Now, granted, they don't have a recreation department. I understand that. They're not doing the jail program that we're doing. I understand that. But even if you factor those two items out, still 1.5 less employees of a population of 140,000, that's a lot of employees. Their budget, their general fund, where ours is 133 million as of 2008-2009, their general fund 2008-2009 is 114 million. That's what, roughly $19 million less than ours with comparable populations, in my opinion. Davidson has one quarter less employees per 1,000 population. Their 2008-2009 general fund, 122 million. Ours, again, 133, was 133, $9 million difference. I know that's not scientific, that's not apples to apples, but it's fruit to fruit. And it's just hard for me to think that we've done as good as we can do in paring this budget down to meet the times. I mean, there's people out here that don't know where their next rent payment's coming from. They don't, and a lot of people, they don't know how they're going to buy groceries. Social Security recipients aren't going to get a tax, an increase this year, I understand, as far as their checks. It's just hard for me to keep stomaching the situation of we're doing the best that we can and we're at the bone. I don't believe we're the only county government out of 100 nor out of 3,000 in the United States that has got it as lean and mean as it can be. I honestly don't believe that. So I just, if we're going to leave those employees in there, the eight that we're referring to, and we're not going to make any additional cuts, if we leave those in there, if we're not going to make any additional cuts, I just can't support the budget as submitted. Now, I'll rest my case.
Yeah. Well, I think we can approve a budget tonight and count and you know, take care of the employee situation. One of the things that concerned me, first of all, let me say I think staff did an outstanding job preparing the budget under very tough circumstances. And sometimes we as commissioners have to make the tough decisions, and we need to be prepared to do that. When you look at going into the fund balance, $2.76 million, I have concerns about that, and I'll tell you why. Number one, we're still in this revaluation that we're not sure where it's going to end up as far as the final figure when you look at the number of appeals that we still have outstanding. And then certainly the second thing is the when you look at the sales tax revenue for the year, and sales are down in many things, we don't know where that's going to end. That plus the economy, as Tim stated, and the people, and as they're suffering, we need to really be more so than ever conservative in terms of the budget this year. And because of that, now one thing I heard, Craig, that I really liked, that maybe staff, maybe you were playing with the idea of possibly when a position comes open, here with the county, that you will have maybe postpone filling that position for 90 days, that you will have an assessment done by the department head, and then you will make a determination as to whether that position is needed or not. Is that pretty, did I hit that pretty close?
Yes, sir. And there are going to be positions that come open that are either grant funded or public safety that are necessary to be funded. But for those that we can't, we are going to have that 90-day hold on each position. And again, to see if there are ways we can do things a little bit differently, hold off, but it would also give us a cushion on our departmental budgets for the upcoming year as well.
Well, I think that's a great idea, and that could start maybe eliminating some of the jobs that we don't need, cutting the fat. And so I think that's a great idea. And with that comment that I just made, let me talk about the trail and open space coordinator just a minute. I was pretty much prepared to omit that from the budget tonight until last week. I had the opportunity to sit down with a young man who was, he was interviewing me for his life merit badge with the Boy Scouts. And he explained to me the importance of having the ability to canoe, to fish, to camp along this corridor. And when I got to thinking about that and thinking about young people and getting back to the roots and you know, and this things in the past, I said, you know what? This is a great thing that we're doing here in this county when you look at the Hall River Trail. Not only that, just the fact that when you look at the economy today, people are not going to be traveling like they used to be. They're going to be looking locally to do things locally. So we, this is a, for $14,000, we can have a coordinator that's out here, the money that we're spending to do this, it can be overseeing it and looking after it, and I think that's a great idea. So, but other than that, I'm ready to make a motion now, Madam Chair, if
well,
you'd like for me to.
Well, I think we need to make sure everybody's through.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
Well, and then I would entertain the motion.
Okay. I'm pretty much in agreement with Dan on that, Craig. I appreciate you guys cutting all you have so far. Out of those eight positions, if we had to prioritize those positions, where would we go? I know you need to go back to the heads.
I would probably have to go back to the department heads. I know we are hurting in the library. With respect to additional overtime in the library, but we can go back to the department heads as well. You know, if we have to delay the positions, we can do that as well. If we need to delay another 3 months or another six, we can do and make work whatever this board would like us to do.
What if we delay them for 6 months?
Well, that's what I was going to suggest in my motion.
Yeah, and I mean, I just need to get a consensus. I mean, yeah. Maybe get a feeling of what if we delayed it for 6 months? I mean, that would help.
That's how they got out of the mix as it was. Right. They were being delayed.
Exactly.
And,
well, we can delay it 6 more months.
The six positions right now would be $120,000
if you delayed them for
6 months.
I would still recommend it.
And part of that we could put back towards fund balance. And one of the things that Amy and I have talked about is our fund balance is approximately 16% now. But it is something that we are going to recommend that we look at a fund balance policy of a minimum level where we need to be. And we're going to probably bring that to the board in the next couple of months to look at.
So, Edie, what was your concern about?
Well, that was the main thing. If we could delay those, I think that would work. I'm with Dan on this Hall River Trail because I really believe that that's one of the big attributes we have in our county. We're actually becoming known for our Hall River Trail, and even the wineries are getting classified as the Hall River Wineries. I know that from Mrs. Stikeleather. But I would just say if we can hold off on those for at least 6 months, that would.
Other than the whole thing.
Right.
Yeah.
Can we prioritize those, Craig? Those that we feel that are most important and just do it in steps?
We can do it in steps. We can do it anyway.
I know they're all important. I understand.
Right.
That.
We can, you know, bring them back every 3 months and maybe bring back a position or two every 3 months for you to review. You know, again,
check the economy at that time, sales tax, et cetera.
We're going to do the internal review, you know, for most new positions that do come open. But we'll be more than happy to do that and bring that back to the board as well.
I'd be fine with it if it go in steps.
We can work on that as well. Yes, ma'am.
I want to just say one other thing about the Hall River Trail specialist there. He doesn't work for Hall River. I want everybody to know that. But the thing about it, he writes grants. He does a lot of other things, which I had somebody to come up and think. All he does is walk up and down the trail, but that's not what he does. He does a lot of other things. I know he writes grants, and he just helps with them and gets them started. And he's actually brought a lot to Alamance County since he came here as far as the Hall River Trail. So just want to comment on that. He doesn't just walk up and down the trail every day, so and looking at it.
Well, it's not every day. It's Saturdays and Sundays, is it?
No, that's the part-time.
That's the part-timer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, we do have a part-time man too, and, but this is the full-time man, okay? So, he works all weekend, okay? But I just wanna comment on that. Is there any other, what we need to do is do the stipulations as what we would like to ask Tim.
Yeah, I'd like to say, I said I would rest my case.
That's okay.
So I've rested the case, but I wanna make a plea, please. A year ago, I asked that we consider performance-based budget. We went down to Davidson County, Assistant County Manager and I, or the interim county manager, maybe at that time. We went down and sat and met with them. Here we are a year later, and we're no closer to doing something about it than I am closer to the White House. I don't understand why it takes so long to do some things when there's some good ideas out there. And I can say that over the last 12 months, I've made a couple of cases that I thought was fairly well studied, fairly well researched, and I can't control, all I can do is have one vote. And I do what I do, but I've never seen such an effort to, in my opinion, further the arena of the areas that I was looking at versus having some self-introspection, if that's the right word, of that we can do it better, we can do it leaner, we can be more efficient. Everybody says, most people say, we're as efficient as we can be. I don't buy that for a minute. And I can't blame our new county manager because he's only been here for a month, roughly. But I challenge you to not try to be, this is just Tim Sutton speaking, not try to win a popularity contest with county employees. Get in there in each department and knock heads with them. Look at the surveys that are out there. Look at the evidences that are out there and try to get us leaner than we are. And hopefully we can do better than I think we're going to do tonight. But I do respect your position. And I know you haven't been able to do a lot since you've been here. Godspeed, but private business does it differently government, I can assure you.
Well, if I could also mention your idea on performance-based budgeting, maybe something we look at next year, and talking with the assistant county manager, he thought the trip that you had to Davidson really was a very beneficial thing, and it will be something if this board is would like us to, we will look at that and try to do that for next year's budget. There's a couple things before you vote.
Okay.
Number one, as you're aware, that we are not recommending a cost of living for our employees. With the board's blessings, we would like to recommend the 5 bonus days and making sure that that is part of the approval of this budget. The other thing we need to do is talk about, if we do approve the budget ordinance, do we change the Hall River rate to 12.5 cents at their request? So
we ran into this I think it was it, Tim, was it last budget year or the one before? And where we had the same thing, and basically, if we knew more about it, I would say fine, but I don't want to vote on it tonight based on what, so it's just a matter of too late. It's my personal opinion. If we'd have known, say, a week ago, I could understand that, but coming in right here, right before the budget time, I can't support it under those circumstances.
Well, in the past, they would come before us. We had a budget committee that everybody believes now is not needed.
Yeah.
And everybody would come before us way before this vote and put out their case. I mean, I've seen things in our budget just go from $25,000 to $85,000. I mean, it's just... I don't know what evidences are being shown as to why people need increases. The Historical Society got 25 last time they sat before us in a budget session. Budget committee, and I looked in the budget, it's 85,000.
Not saying they don't deserve that, but having went from 25 to 85 is beyond me.
And one of the things we can do in the upcoming year, one of the things I do want to compliment staff on, and especially Amy and Susan, is how they formulated the recommended budget. And I think I've heard comments from all board members about how well they did and how good a job was done in putting the information together. And again, I want to thank them. I think they did an absolute wonderful job in getting that information together, making it readable and easy to understand, and appreciate MIS for getting it on the website as quickly as well. But again, we can do things different. You know, if we need to do a workshop one day and talk about things to change as far as the budget process, we can do that as well.
This has been the easiest budget to follow, the manager's recommendations of any that I've seen since I've been on the board, and I've been told by several people that's read it online that they said it was, you know, it's really good as far as simple, you know, as far as reading it, and that's a good thing. So you did a very good job with that.
Did a great job.
So if we vote tonight on the fire tax issue, then they would just have the same thing they had and not go
be
down?
Be the 10-5.
I mean, and all the others would have the same thing that they had. Yeah. I just want to make that clear, that we wouldn't either reduce or add.
Well, one fire department, AO, is increasing, and then there's two fire departments that were actually decreasing.
Okay. Okay, if we're ready, I'll entertain a motion of some sort, whatever.
Madam Chair, I'll make a motion that we approve the budget as written by the county manager with the following changes. That we omit the eight frozen positions, that we postpone looking at filling those positions until January 1st of this budget year. Then the manager may bring them back up on a need basis. That we do omit the increases recommended by the Hall River Fire Department, just based on the fact that we didn't receive it until tonight. To consider, and other than that, that's my motion. And yes, I'm sorry, and that we do include the request for the position in recreation, where the county will pay a sum of $14,000 for the trail and open space coordinator.
Okay, I have a motion on the floor.
I'll second that.
I have a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
That motion carries. Okay. All right. At this time, we'll do the county manager report.
I have nothing else at this moment. Just also to clarify, that did include the five bonus days for our employees.
Include the five bonus days for employees.
Yes. Okay. I'm sorry.
Five bonus days.
I think that was part of that was in your book and part of your recommendation. Yes, sir.
Okay. But at this point, I have nothing else.
Okay. And on the now we'll go to the consent agenda. Does anybody want to pull any of that? I think we all have that, the resolutions. Second reading of ordinances, the resolution opposing the proposed state tobacco tax increase, and our minutes.
Motion to pass consent.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. No opposed. At this time, we are going to go into a closed session. Yeah, I've got to find the paper so I can read what I'm asking. Which says, I move that we now go into closed session pursuant to North Carolina General Statute Section 143-318.11A6 to consider the qualifications and conditions of appointment or conditions of initial employment of a public officer or employees. Do I hear a motion?
Motion.
I have a motion. A second. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Okay. We shall return. We hope this won't be very long.